Hey everybody, Star here. What is going on? We are taking a closer look at the Flying Guillotine secondary weapon for the Scout recently added in the Triad Pack update, and I'm so glad that it did in fact get added because I am falling in love with this weapon. I really think we might be getting married pretty soon. I loved it when it first came out, but now that I've had a day or two to mess around with it and become acquainted with my hatchet, the throwing arc, and some of the stuff like that, I really like this weapon. Not even just for the Sandman gimmick and for the fact that, well, your ragdoll goes nuts when you get hit with this item. Look at this heavy. Just, he throws his minigun on the floor and just goes flying because he enjoyed it as much as I did. Not only is this weapon really fun to use, but it opens up ridiculous new possibilities for Scout, where there is absolutely no way prior to this hatchet I would have been able to one-shot that medic off of Spire and kill him that way without putting myself at any risk whatsoever. Because it is a 150 damage critical that is just enough to one-shot a medic. Anything that one-shots a medic is pretty scary. Not only that, but if you're doing the Sandman combo, it stuns them beforehand, which is already kind of inconvenient for a medic or anyone, really. Going all out and doing the Sandman hatchet combo is a little bit of a gimmick. It's kind of weird. I'd like to compare it to something like the Market Gardener, where you're going out of your way to do something kind of stupid, but it can give you some pretty awesome rewards. But the hatchet is a lot better than the Market Gardener because you don't have to actually physically jump at people. You can stay at a distance and still throw this weapon, which is why in a lot of these clips I'm going to be using the Force of Nature, where I'm not really running in on people trying to use my scatter gun every couple of seconds. What I really just want to do is throw my hatchet, get the 150, kill people that way, and if they come in on me, I can force them backwards with the Force of Nature, get my two quick shots, and then let my Sandman recharge again. That is the plan, but unfortunately, it's not as easy as it might sound, or maybe it doesn't even sound easy, and you get the point, that to hit somebody with the Sandman and then the hatchet in quick succession is not something you could just, you know, I'm gonna do it and just pull it off every single time that you try it. Even after you hit somebody with the Sandman, they're stunned, they can still wiggle around a little bit, and at medium to long range distances, them wiggling at a snail's pace is enough for them to actually dodge the hatchet that you're trying to throw at them. The difference between hitting and missing your shots is obviously a big deal, where right here I miss on that heavy, and because I wasted all my time trying to do the Sandman gimmick, I end up dying, and the heavy after I was dead had 150 health exactly, just to taunt me so he can say, you know, if you'd hit your hatchet, I would have been dead, and we all could have pushed through there, probably captured the point, there's a heavy down, I had tons of teammates behind me ready for that guy to die, and the difference between missing and hitting is really just, if you're going to hit your shots, you're probably making a really awesome play. You're killing somebody you couldn't have killed before, 150 damage instantly, awesome stuff. If you miss your shot, you really are wasting a lot of your time trying to pull this off. Even if you manage to hit the Sandman shot, actually stun them, and then you miss the hatchet, that was still a big waste of your time because you could have just as easily Sandman them, then walked forward and hit them with the scattergun a few times. So, to a certain extent, this is a really pointless combo where there's no reason to do it. If you want to use the Sandman, you could just as easily shotgun somebody. But at the same time, there are opportunities where there's no way you could have pulled that off with just the shotgun. There's no way you could have killed someone that quickly and with that much style swag, you know what I mean? However, if you're not just going for the ridiculous guillotine hatchet combo instant kill nonsense, the guillotine by itself is still a really, really effective item because if you're throwing it at medium range, you're going to be doing 50 damage with the initial hit. And at about medium range, a scattergun shot that's well placed will do about 50 damage, so you're not really missing out too much there. But then it does an additional 40 bleed damage over time, and because of how fast it recovers a lot faster than a Sandman if you haven't noticed. It's worth just throwing these things out there every now and again to annoy people with the bleed damage and to sort of chase your hatchet in. You throw it, you hit somebody with it, you get the 50 damage, they start bleeding, and then you follow that up by chasing them down with the scattergun. You can also easily consider the hatchet a replacement for the pistol, because it quite literally is a replacement for the pistol. It is a secondary slot item that deals damage, and it has the exact same purpose that the pistol does, where when you're finally out of primary weapon shots, you have something to help you deal damage on the secondary slot, so you don't just need to reload your scattergun or something like that. And personally, I love the hatchet a lot more for this, because the pistol has random bullet spread, and for me it feels like the pistol shots just go around people, like they decide they don't want to hit somebody based on random bullet spread, where with the hatchet I feel more in control. And if I hit somebody, I know it's because I properly aimed it, and if I miss, it's because I know I threw it really stupidly, and it's not just as random as the pistol is. I like to go for that one good shot that you know is going to be reliable, follow up with the bleed damage, and there you go. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. That is it. It is over. I will catch you guys next time for the next Team Fortress 2 video. Peace out, everybody.
Control point.